Hey, this episode is brought to you by NatureBox. NatureBox.com. You do that a lot. I say the thing and then you just repeat it in a
slower
voice. Yeah,
that way it sounds like I'm contributing.
Yeah.
When I don't actually do anything.
So what is NatureBox? They basically send you delicious and nutritious snacks to you over the mail, and you don't even have to pay for shipping. They will pay for the shipping to give you snacks.
And they're delicious and nutritious.
What else do you need? And these are snacks that I didn't even know that I liked until I got them. We were lucky enough to get some snacks to try out before we actually purchased them. And we got delicious. I mean,
delicious and nutritious? Man, that's vicious.
It's suspicious, but I assure you, Aloysius, it is the case.
And it is not fictitious.
I've consumed over 17 pounds of French toast granola, which was amazing. The salted caramel pretzel pops were also insanely good. We basically ate that the entire train ride up, and you know, stuff
up
that
to
I
Boston. Didn't, nobody knows where we were, what train ride you're talking about.
stuff
we
that
ate that on the train ride.
You know the train. Everyone knows about our train ride.
We were on the train, as you all know,
the big train ride that was on like U.S. News and World Report. How they ranked us third most popular train ride.
Oh, man.
It's also food that I didn't even know that I liked, like pumpkin seeds and sunflower seeds, like flavored little seeds.
The sea salt and cracked pepper.
Yeah.
It's funny how you just put sea and cracked in front of salt and pepper, and it's just like it makes it sound and is so much better. I don't even know what that means, but like it's cracked pepper. Isn't all pepper cracked?
This pepper is all it's cracked up to be. So check out NatureBox. No. It really is very delicious. And it's very affordable, and it's even more affordable if you use our coupon code, which is If I Were You.
Damn right.
So go to naturebox.com and use our coupon code and get 50% off your first box. And if you do, please forward us the receipt and we'll give you a shout out next time we plug this wonderfully delicious, amazing company. So thank you, NatureBox, and thanks guys for tuning in. This was a fun episode. Pat was on it.
Yeah, you guys, shit gets real. I know I say that every single time, but really, shit got real.
Pat openly wept for close to half an hour. We had to cut that part out.
Before we started the podcast, too.
Yeah, and then we launched right into it. So, yes, enjoy the episode, everyone.
That was the Chemical Brothers live in the studio.
Huge fans. I'm rolling face right now.
It's 1 p.m. and you're sweating right now.
Man, I fucking have a dry mouth.
I haven't seen those pacifier necklaces in a few years.
Yep. LED pacifier necklace. This is not the kind for babies. This is the kind for adults.
How can you tell?
You've done no drugs yet.
I'm just about to.
It's pure music, man. Music is my drug. Also drugs.
Yeah. Music stands for methamphetamine, Uber X.
That I take to meet my drug dealer for...
Which is a great service.
That was submitted by a user named Nofel, K-N-O-F-L-E. Nofel.
Wow. What part of Sweden is he from?
He moves around a lot. He's actually from Iowa.
Oh, really? That's where Captain Kirk is from, actually.
Hey, it's Pat Cassels, everyone.
Yeah, Did you not tell when he said where Captain Kirk was
Who
from?
Set the over-under on Captain Kirk references to a minute and a half of the podcast, and he just got it in. Just got a shade under the minute and a half mark.
The winner is nobody.
This is If I Were You, the only advice podcast on the internet hosted by us. I'm Amir.
And I'm Jake. And
I am Patrick. Is that was the idea?
No, we usually don't say a single word until we introduce you, but you just, you said the first thing on the podcast.
Amazing.
Actually.
It took balls. It took gumption. It took a complete lack of tact.
Lack of tact and attractive act.
I wanted to make sure you guys knew off the bat that like, I'm a cool dude. I'm ready to talk. I'm ready to jest with one another.
You lacked tact, in fact.
I did not lack tact, Mac.
In fact, he did lack tact.
Take that back. I didn't lack tact.
You tacked and lacked. You really did tact.
I appreciate if that statement would be retracted.
Just Seinfeld genes are growing around your guys' legs right now.
Well, thanks for coming on the show. This is actually pretty exciting. It's our 30th episode.
Oh, wow.
So you're on the big 3-0.
Big 3-0.
We'll never have another 30th episode.
No.
That's true. Unless the universe repeats itself as some... physicist theory.
Leave the
show. Thank you for having me so much. I'm so sorry I even said that in the first place. I'm honored. I'm honored to be. Thank you for having me.
You said you listen to the show, but it sounds like in a way you just listen to like three episodes really like on 2x speed on the way over here, and like that was your like. Like, yeah, I listen to the show. So, like, how does it work? Like, do we answer questions?
Hey, guys, love the show.
I didn't ask that broad of a question.
But how many episodes have you listened to?
You're taking this.
No, absolutely, I want
to
know.
Right now?
I want to embarrass him in front of everybody.
No, I'm going to be completely honest with you guys. I've listened to every episode, beginning to end, three times.
Holy crap.
That's crazy. You specifically said you didn't listen to the Pete Holmes episode yet.
Well, that's, like, brand new.
Oh, not that episode.
Yeah,
other ones.
Also, that one's a kind of, that was like a sort of special episode.
Yeah, right? Yeah, that didn't count.
Which turned me off. Anyway, but basically, we talk about what's happening in the world of business. Right? This is mad money.
You have three business insider magazines curled up into a ball in your back pocket.
I've listened to the show. I haven't listened to every episode.
I don't really care. I was just razzing you.
You're really me. Yeah. So right now.
Pat knows how it works.
Yeah.
Let's explain to the audience how it works.
Yeah, yeah.
Pat can help. People email us in their sticky situations, their conundrums, and we do our best to help them get out of them.
And sometimes it's just us two, and sometimes we have our friends on.
And this time we have Pat. Oh, come on, man.
I like to move it, move it. I like to move it.
I can take some razzing. I'm not like, it's
you're
fine.
Steaming.
Yeah, you are clenching my thigh very hard right
now. I get it. I
get
it. You prod the new guy because you love him.
Yeah.
It's totally fine.
And that's usually the case. So why don't we try to get started?
Let's do it.
If you want to submit a theme song or an email to us, that email is ifiwereyoushow@gmail.com.
gmail.com.
So these are real emails from real people, and we're going to give them fake names. And Pat said he would have a good theme for today's episode. So Pat, what would you say if this was written by a guy? What should we call him?
I would say this would be Apollo.
Okay, so
Apollo.
Apollo writes.
Surprised he didn't say Captain Kirk.
Enough, all right? Already razzed him quite enough, actually.
You started this.
No.
And that's also very light razzing.
Compared to what you did, which was deliberately call him out within the first 4 minutes of the show. All right, ready?
Yes.
Apollo writes, "What up, my nerds? What up, my nerds? That being said, my question to you fellows is how to manipulate..."
I love this guy. Oh, I wrote this one. What's your show about? Signed sincerely,
Apollo. All right, here we go. Apollo writes, "What's up, my nerds? That being said, my question to you fellows is how to manipulate my girlfriend into losing weight. She's pretty hot now, easily a 7 out of 10, at least. And she's not fat, but she can lose weight. I am in impeccable shape, and I just don't understand why everybody can't just eat right and work out. Any tips, Apollo?"
You see what I look like right now. Why would you bring me on for this question?
Well, this is just how to manipulate a girl to lose weight.
Wow, that's a provocative one.
Or should you?
Yeah.
Well, right.
He didn't ask that. And we won't infer.
Oh,
we won't
God.
Make our own questions.
I have to answer this question?
Yeah. So how do you manipulate your girlfriend, someone you love, into losing weight?
She's a 7 to say the least.
And she's not fat, but she could lose some weight.
Yeah, because, you know, she's not at the bare minimum of weight,
and
which
of course
is with the weight you are when you die.
He's in impeccable shape, so...
He just doesn't understand why everybody can't eat right now.
I think it might be peckable. I have doubts that it's somewhat peckable.
Yeah. His pecs are probably impeccable.
Oh, very
so here's
nice.
What you do, buddy. You're going to, all right, go into your dining room and just stand about 5.5 to 6 feet away from the table, okay? And then just fall forward as fast as you can. Don't brace yourself.
What?
You're going to smack your head and face on the table, and hopefully it sort of knocks some sense into you, or at least breaks your face, because I think you deserve to have your face broken.
Jesus.
Yeah, I think he deserves it to be beaten up for this.
But not by a human, by some sort of weird freak accident.
He's got to do it himself.
And he has to fall forward?
I think he should fall forward onto his face near a table.
And like where? Hit his forehead or something?
I would think like his teeth and nose. If he wants to fall side face, that's gonna hurt his eye socket, his teeth, his nose, and maybe his ear.
Baby, what happened to you?
I fell down on purpose onto a table and I
thought
I hurt
you were
my
in
face.
Impeccable shape. How did this happen? What's wrong with you?
I'm very suggestible.
Mm. As a 700-pound woman, I'm concerned about your health.
Oh my
sorry.
I'm eating you.
So he's in impeccable shape, but he can only get a 7 out of 10. So I imagine
it's
got a lot to do with his personality, or maybe his face is bad to be.
Or maybe with. Maybe he's not impeccable.
You could be in impeccable shape but still be ugly.
Impeccable is a relative term too.
Totally.
You know, like in the early 20th century. To be a rotund fat man was considered like the most desirable body because it meant you were fat and wealthy and you could eat a lot of chicken and stuff.
Eat chicken and hands.
Like a Rockefeller type. You have a big old belly and you're just a fat cat.
Whoa, yeah. That guy. I think that guy eats chicken and ham.
But now it's like Richard Branson's the new millionaire and he's a fucking stud. Actually, that question was from Richard Branson, I think.
I'm a Playboy billionaire with a perfect body. How do I manipulate my badass girlfriend? I hang out in space sometimes.
She's not fat. She could just lose weight.
I mean, the genuine answer is, you know, yeah, you should not, you know.
It is a very shallow thing to say. Although, but if you... Let's zoom out a little bit. If you fell in love with
way
someone,
out, because this woman is so huge.
I mean, she
you gotta
is
be
enormous.
Like different...
She is. Let's not get stuck in her gravitational pull. I mean, Jesus Christ.
The word that really that bothers me is manipulate.
Yes.
I think that like this would be such a nice if it's a genuine question.
You have to trick her, like replace soda with diet soda, right. Or like chicken with tuna fish.
Inject steroids into her shampoo so she like moves around more.
You know what should ask advice on how to manipulate people.
Yeah, manipulate's a very loaded word. Well, it worked out well. I manipulated her, and now she's thin again.
It's perfect. Yeah, I've sort of got her under my thumb in that regard.
I've sort of tricked her into losing what must be 30 to 35 pounds just through a weird suggestive a wordplay.
I think I basically hypnotized my girlfriend to like salad more than sandwiches.
Yeah, like every visual in my head is like putting things in pies that shouldn't be there and like just gaslighting her.
Can I inception her to lose weight? I'd love to inception her, like to just get down deep into her psyche and make it so that she's afraid of carbs.
I like the idea of using inception as a verb.
Yeah, and can I inception her?
How do I inception her?
I want to inception her to a paleo diet, I think. I want to suggest that the caveman knew what they were doing.
Well, we have to go 13 layers deep because she's so fat that
she just wakes
up. The first 9 dream levels are about chicken, so we have to.
She just wakes up wanting lasagna because you didn't get deep inside him enough.
Ass, no.
I feel like we love the fat jokes on a purely visceral level. It doesn't mean anything.
Yeah,
right?
We don't actually know what this girl looks like.
She's not fat. She's a 7 out of 10, easy.
She's a and she's that's three away from a goddamn
who,
dime.
Yeah, I mean, shit. That's cool, man. You're a piece of shit, though.
Yeah, would you ever rank your girlfriend? Would you ever, like, when you... When you first see someone, maybe you can assign a numerical
value. Yeah, I rank people all the time.
But, like, have you ever ranked your girlfriend?
Yeah.
You know what your girlfriends are?
Yeah, at least according to me.
What are they?
They were... a 7, an 8, a 9, a 7.
Jesus Christ. This is so fucking honest.
Yeah.
That's your social security
number.
What was
it like going from a 9 to a 7?
It was hard.
Like
but
you had drank the milk of paradise, and now you're back to reality.
Well, there are other things to put, like, put into account, like,
how would you rate their personality?
Face, but like a better ass.
Yeah,
if that makes sense.
How would you rank their personality?
Four.
I'm just joking.
That being said, 4, 4, 1, 9, God. And 3.
Wow, you should have never gotten rid of the 9 or 9.
But she was the 7.
Yeah.
This guy sounds incredibly shallow. And
you're
so
talking about Jake.
No, the dude who wrote the question sounds incredibly shallow. And, you know, I personally do not, I've never assigned a numerical value to a woman, except that she's number 1 to me.
You fucking loser.
No, but just to play this guy's game for a second.
Well, this is coming from a dude who's only dated fat chicks, am I right?
Thank you.
Stop.
Yeah. It's like Pat manipulated the skinny ones to be bigger. I mean, Jesus Christ, man.
Whoa.
I mean, I've heard of taking her out to dinner, but
mean anyone near him looks like a goddamn whale, I swear.
Yeah,
to God.
Him and any girl looks like the number 10.
String beans go great with ham.
Closer to the bone and sweeter is the meat.
I oh God.
But his okay, just to play his game for a second, his definition of a 7 is probably not, I'm not going to take that at face value, you know? Like, it's, I bet his 7 is like my 13, you know?
Oh, so you're saying he's ranking her low?
Probably.
Well, he seems like he's not very self-aware at all, too. He's like, I'm in impeccable shape. Nothing's wrong with me. How do I manipulate my girlfriend to get as good-looking as I am?
I think
like he's a narcissist.
Do you vet these questions at all? Like,
yeah. So this wasn't just completely chosen at random. We chose someone who did sound like a loser on purpose.
I didn't mean to like open up.
I will say, all right, let's do this. We'll do like O.J. Simpson, you know, like if I did it, this is what it would be.
Yeah.
So like if I wanted to do this, if I wanted to manipulate the girl into getting thin.
Yeah.
Here's what you would say, you make it like a team thing. Like,
yeah, let's go to the gym together.
Like, oh, let's go on hikes together. Let's start cooking at home.
Oh.
Let's exercise together. Let's get healthy together. Not like you need to do this. You're unattractive.
Right.
Because maybe if I take away the manipulating thing, maybe if he like likes this girl for her personality, thinks she's great, but just wants her to be healthier.
Do you think there's anything to the idea that if a woman gains weight while she's with you, you can become less attracted to her? It's a little bit of a bait and switch.
For me, I can't, because like the bigger that ass gets, the more I'm in love. You know?
Absolutely.
That badonk. Donk.
Sorry, can you stop doing that noise?
The Kanye?
Yeah, the yeah. I don't
Did
want
he do that.
That.
Is that a thing? You do?
I don't want that.
I think a lot of rappers do it, but I mean,
I think a lot of gooses do. A lot of geese do that.
Geese and rappers.
Oh, yeah, that's what's up, man. I love bread.
Yeah, bread,
bread, pond, 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 bread,
my bones are hollow,
land some eggs, land eggs, sit in the nest,
Kanye just starts growing a beak, holy shit, he's a goddamn goose,
I'm into
Affleck
it,
duck.
I'm sorry he's changing your paradigm of what rap can be,
no, look at him, he's picking up a slice of bread off the grass with only his beak mouth, he's throwing it in the air,
Yeezy.
Geezy.
Take it easy, Yeezy.
Geezus.
Can't. Geezus.
300 Geezus. What are the Trojans?
Like we've hurt this guy enough and given him some advice. You should also maybe be honest with your girlfriend and say that you want her to...
I'll go further. I will say I dislike his girlfriend.
Wow.
Yeah.
She said nothing wrong.
When yes,
you say
she has.
Go further, you've gone too far.
No, absolutely not. I have not.
Because I bet she's, yeah,
this is a girl who is with this guy for a year, so she's probably a piece of shit too.
Interesting.
You guys are staring at me like I just suggested we beat someone up. No. You're just like,
I was momentarily wondering if there's any logic to that.
I'm not on board with you.
Are asshole guys, can they only attract terrible women?
No, lots of girls fall for assholes.
Yeah. I don't know. I don't have that bitter. I'm single. Full disclosure.
We know.
Anyway, tell us more about Captain Kirk's... I'm kidding, dude.
Kirk was the biggest pimp in the galaxy. FYI.
So what you're doing right now is sort of backfiring.
Wow, it's like you're embarrassing yourself right now.
Maybe if you mentioned Spock or some shit.
Because that, yeah, he couldn't clean up.
All right, wait, so say what you're going to say. You're single, full disclosure.
Yeah, but like... No, the idea of like ask, do girls attract, what was it?
Only terrible girls be with terrible guys?
I mean, I've never had that bitterness that some guys have of like, oh, like why is she with that douchebag? But I have heard that's kind of a truism that like girls will often wind up with jerks.
But yeah. I also think
I've
that,
but I've never, I've definitely been bested by men, or I've had girls that I like be attracted to other guys, but they're never total assholes. But right. they become assholes once they...
they're not with me.
All guys do. All guys are assholes sometimes. Like, maybe this guy is actually nice to her. He's just writing a mean email behind her back, which makes him an asshole. But, like, yeah. maybe, like... He hasn't, like, done anything yet. He probably treats her pretty well.
He did all call all of us nerds in the beginning of the letter.
I do love the beginning made me laugh before I even got to the question. I'm glad the question was good. But it says, "What's up, my nerds? That being said, my question to you..." Like, you didn't say anything. You just saluted us.
He's like a weird mafia don who just took an English class. Like, "That being said, therefore, forego the following query to henceforth the following query to use as gentlemen."
Sounds like we're out of time when you do that.
No, it's not. It's heh.
H E H H C H U G H. Can you use that in a sentence?
Yes. The goose went.
Dave Rosenberg, you my boy.
Okay, and can you say the Latin? Does it have Latin roots, Greek roots?
It's sort of, I think it comes from like, ha ha, in your face, I'm richer than you. You
all know, right.
Like,
like sort of like bragging, I think.
H-H-E-C-C-H-H-G-H.
Now you were losing for being in the spelling bee.
But you did spell it correctly.
That being said.
Henceforth, ergo. Cogito, ergo sum.
The following query I propose verily to use his guys.
Yeah, I guess I did go too far. I shouldn't say that this girl's an asshole. There's lots of really nice girls with asshole guys.
Right. I think you should, number one, respect your girlfriend. Number two, if you want her to be healthier and you think it would make her happier, then there's a positive way to go about this that feels inclusive and brings you two closer together rather than you being a manipulative asshole.
Yeah, but this girl's not fat, so like she doesn't have to lose weight, it sounds like. That's just a purely aesthetic thing. It's not like a health thing yet.
How do you know she's not fat?
Because he says she's not fat.
Like, I'm not saying like obesity.
So she's not fat, like, but he just wants her to be thinner?
Yes.
But obesity,
you can always
be
thinner. Look better.
No, not thinner. Like, I don't know. I don't think she's like, I'm not saying like obese, unhealthy. I'm just saying like a healthier lifestyle.
Yeah. It really doesn't matter as long as they're in a normal weight range. So like this guy is saying that she's not fat, but he wants her lady to lose weight. So he can either get used to what her current weight is and suck it up, or find someone else if you want someone skinnier.
Yeah, if she's not morbidly, unhealthily obese, then he has no right telling her to like lose weight. If it's not, you know, if he should just leave, that relationship would end for her sake as well as his. Like, it's not, if she's of a normal, healthy weight, he has no right to demand she change her body.
Dude, that's why you're single. I mean, I swear to God, like that attitude, that's not going to get you. Play.
Really?
It really won't.
All right, just tell me what to do.
You gotta...
I'm a sponge, bro.
You gotta replace sandwiches with salads from day one.
Put cocaine in her salt.
All right, are we done here?
I think so. I mean, I don't know that we've given him any definitive advice.
Sure you did. You said turn it into a team-building activity. She could probably stand to lose a few pounds.
That's not what I said.
How dare you, actually, for even suggesting that. I would never do that.
If she's happy, then fuck off. But if she wants... Like, if there's people that are like, unhealthy and they want to be healthier, they just, like, can't, like, motivate themselves to do it.
All right. I'm done with this guy. Let's go on to the next question.
This clown.
This ass clown. This ass. So this one is from, this next email is from a lady. Pat, you got a name for us?
Oh, yeah, from a lady, Rosalind.
Okay, Rosalind writes, "Dear guys, I'm a 20-year-old female in college, and I just got dumped by a guy that I was in a long-distance relationship with for 3 years. He decided that after all this time, he wasn't ready for a commitment. As a student in engineering, I have plenty of guys to check out. Basically, like shooting fish in a barrel. But I'm a bit rusty at getting the nerve to talk to the ones I'm super attracted to. How do I let a guy know that I'm interested in him? I really want to show this new guy that I'm completely available, and if he plays his cards right, open for business. Any tips, tricks, and turn-ons would be very useful."
I've never...
I can't believe she's like, I'm... That pool of engineering students.
Yeah. She also went from super confident to very unconfident in one email.
So she got... any Iranian transfer student she wants, really.
It's like shooting fish in a barrel. That being said, I don't have the courage or nerve to approach the ones that I find
attractive. Have a gun or a bullet or a barrel.
What I have is an ocean of fish, and I am sort of lost, alone, confused, and scared.
This is not a metaphor. I just have a pile of rancid fish in my living room.
That being said, I have been hooking up with one of the fish.
I put a trout in my vagina not 2 hours ago, and I am feeling more than a little bit frisky.
I am so desperate.
There's a goddamn tuna fish inside me, and I'm wondering how to hook up with an engineer. Any help you can provide would be
rubbing
very helpful.
Rubbing a California
helpful.
Roll on my clit right now.
Oh, God. How dare you?
You said put a tuna in your vagina.
How dare you? Yeah.
I painted a little bit more of a picture.
You turned the
chicken of the sea, and C stands for clit.
Joke of the trip. Joke
wow.
of the clit.
Wow. Okay, so it seems like a pretty straightforward question. She's just a nice young lady who wants advice on how to
approach
guys.
Girls don't need advice to how to approach guys.
I agree.
That's no, that is not that
guys
not
need advice. Girls are open for girls are the tough ones to gain. If you're a girl and you like a guy, you just have to talk to him.
I do like it when girls just come up and initiate conversation. I know as a dude, like, it's the onus is kind of on me, I suppose. So when that paradigm is sort of shaken up a little bit, it's a pleasant to me. It's a pleasant surprise.
I like that advice. What's onus? What's paradigm?
I was too busy getting my dick sucked.
I think that's good. I think that's actually really smart, and I'm with it. What's onus? What's paradigm?
Are these like sex positions I haven't
these
heard
are,
of yet?
Yeah,
because like, that seems highly unlikely.
If that's kind of fish that goes in the sushi, then I will say eel on the clit is funny.
Oh God. Eel on
you
the
have
clit.
Your t-shirt sleeves rolled up right now.
I'd love to eel you up. I really would.
Getting into character, gotta roll up my sleeves. What's a onus? Okay.
I'm almost regretting even saying that now, because now it seems like I'm maybe is it, at this point in history maybe I'm wrong that.
Well, someone you know. Has to be the aggressor when meeting someone. You either have to. There's like two ways to play it. It's like, oh, you see a girl you're attracted to. You can either lay back, act cool, and see if she approaches you, or
send her a Facebook message that's kind of cryptic and obscure that just sort of says like, hey, thought you'd like this movie clip.
Yeah.
Wait 7 months.
And then if she doesn't respond, be like, hey, did you get my thing about the movie clip? This is like when you run into her on the street, be like, and she's like, oh, yeah, maybe. And you'd be like, maybe or okay, I'll resend it because it says, it says
no,
you saw it.
That's but this is like the joke, but it's also it's so true. Like, there's it, there, it's not like when our grandparents met. Think about that. Like, they would go to a USO dance or something, and they had to
USO.
Well, I don't know. Like,
my grandfather was a Nazi.
They'd go. There'd be like a dance. There was a dance,
like an SS
to, like,
march.
Yeah, they had to propose that night because there was like that was the one time you met a girl.
Right.
Like that was it. And now it's like we meet a million people. There's like dating apps. If I like meet a girl at a party, I don't even need to get her number. I can get her information on Facebook. I can send her a friend request. It's the most passive thing in the world. I can follow her on Instagram. I like her photos. She likes mine. It's crazy. There's just a million ways to.
You don't have to ever like take a risk.
Yeah,
you do it digitally a day later,
so
like
passively.
A coward.
Have you guys ever taken a risk though? Have you ever actually done it? Like, because I
like ask someone for their number.
I've asked more than that. Like, I don't know. Been
have you ever asked
boldest,
someone out?
What's the boldest
move
you ever made?
Ooh, that's a good question.
It's like just
in terms of like you know. Proposing a date or whatever.
Hey, this bold move is brought to you by Doritos. The Doritos bold move. Hey, what's the boldest move you've ever taken?
I think that now someone's going to think that Doritos actually sponsored this. Fuck you, Doritos. Doritos fucking suck. Now no one can sell
Nature Box, baby.
We did turn it into a real ad.
So what's your Nature Box bold move of the day? Hey, are you bold?
What's your fuck Doritos bold move sponsored by Nature Box move of the day?
Are you italic?
Don't forget, the bold tent will be at Burning Man all day Sunday.
Are you bold?
Free bags of Doritos to all you movers and shakers out there.
Burning hot sriracha burritos.
Write your emails to us at fireyoushow@gmail.com and use your bold font just to make sure we read it. Are you bold?
Hashtag seize the Dorito.
Anyway.
Seize the Reese.
I fucked a girl on a dance floor at a club one time to a bunch of cheering onlookers.
But enough about how you lost your virginity.
No, I don't, like, boldest move, like kissing a girl when you...
No, like...
Like taking the biggest risk.
Like the movie Say Anything where John Cusack goes to that girl's apartment and holds the radio.
Oh,
like,
that kind of
like a sort of like...
A move where if you fail, it's pretty embarrassing.
Yeah.
Dude, I don't think I've ever done anything where I
have that risk.
Yeah, yeah, it's true. I've told girls that I have feelings for them before, like kind of like straight up. Here's how
out of
I
the
feel.
Blue?
I mean, in my head, I'm like, well, like up until the moment I say it, to me, it's not out of the blue. It's like, you feel this too, right? Like, there's been a thing here for like a couple of months.
This can't be chemistry if only one person's feeling it.
That's not how chemistry works. I mean, I fucked chemistry, but...
Sir, I'm your bus driver. I have no idea what you're talking about.
So that, for me, would be the answer. Not to answer my own question, but...
I guess I've done stuff like that, but I've never, like, made a grand gesture. Nothing where I didn't know for a fact it would be reciprocated.
Well, that's what every, like, first move is. It's like, oh, God, there's that little bit of... The reason that everyone doesn't ask everyone out all the time is the fear of being rejected.
Right.
So there's always, like, a fear of, like, wait, maybe I'm misreading it.
But I get, like, you know... The leap of faith that I take is always so tiny. It's like a little
it's a crack in the floor.
I've like never ever, I guess a couple times, but it's very rare that I'm like, I wonder if this is going to work.
Right.
Usually by that time, it's like a sure thing.
On a few occasions, I've actually like when I get a girl's phone number, I'll be like, this is probably a horrible idea, but I'll be like, hey, what's your number? Like, and they'll give me a number. Like, and like, do you prefer text or phone call?
Oh,
like,
honestly, God, like, yeah, that sucks.
Because no one's ever going to say phone call, so you might as well not even ask.
I don't know. But like, I feel like I've got at some point, like, I've gotten every time I've heard so many like really passionate, like, dude, do not call her. Or,
yeah,
dude,
yeah.
Do not. I definitely heard a dude, not call her, and a dude, do not text her. So I don't know what to do.
No, here's what you do.
So I go to her door, I knock. I'm like, hey.
Unfortunately, I'm crying because I've been so nervous.
I have a bouquet of daisies. All the petals have fallen off, so it just looks like a weird, like, Adam's family.
Some kind of pouring rain. I'm parched. I've been crying my fucking eyes out. I ask her to come in. I see her roommate's kind of pretty. I make a move then and there, trying to kiss her.
On the roommate.
I don't give a shit.
At this point, the Rosies are dead, wet, wilting, and lame. They're just sopping over my wrist.
Also, it's 11 a.m.
on a Tuesday. Nobody's home.
She scurries to the bathroom to get me a towel. I take off my pants, put some peanut butter on my nuts, and I lie on the couch.
I said, honey, don't talk with your mouth full. Make with the yam yams.
Acting like she's some kind of dog that's going to come over. Here, girl.
The dog does come over. I guess he has a dog. Shibu Inu or some shit.
Take the cat out of my butt, out of my nutsack. I'm borderline castrated.
And wouldn't you know it, I shoved some Alpo up my ass just a minute before I came there, not knowing.
She comes in, my dick is in her dog's mouth, I'm bleeding, I'm crying, I'm wet, and I go, hey, do you prefer text or phone calls? She's calling the police at this point.
I'm a goddamn eunuch.
How's that fair?
Wait, what were we going to say, Jake?
Oh, here's what you do. If you like her, get her number. Don't ask if you should text or call. If you like her, just...
Wait, you know what? Nobody needs this advice. All right, let's move on to the next question.
I think if you like her, you call her. It's like baller move. She'll tell her friends. She'll be like...
You never call girls.
I never like them.
Don't you get that? You really don't fucking get it. I haven't yet to respect a girl that I like enough to call. I never like them. That was the most sincere thing I think you've ever said.
It was such a gut reaction, I can't even hide from it.
I like you said it like I was a fucking idiot. You never called someone. I've never liked someone.
Dude.
You fucking idiot.
Is this
liking them means I respect myself enough to gain close to, like, at least to know their personality, and I don't do that.
Ladies out there, if you're offended, I promise you, I hate myself more than anyone possibly could.
You can't hate me more than I. You take a number, sister, because I'm number one.
Come at me. Trust me. I'm beating myself up on the inside every single day.
So you've never phone called a lady that you met because you've never had a crush on them?
Yeah, but I do know guys who have done that, and I've also met girls who are like, and he called me. It's sort of like it's a ballsy move. It's old school, it's romantic, and it's confident.
Also, though, just to, like, in regards to the question, and this, I think everything relates to this, is that I don't know how true this is, but I think if the person, it just comes down to like, if the person is likes you or not, if they'll know,
right,
as soon as they see you and talk to you for like 5 minutes, they'll have a general idea. If like, you know, they're like intrigued, and then if they're into you, there's very little you can do. You know, if you're a normal, well-adjusted person, there's very little I think you could do to like blow it. You know,
that's
like
true.
Everything you do, like calling them, if they don't like you and you call them, you're a creep. If they do like you and you call them, you're like charming and roguishly forward, you know?
Well, that's basically just like be yourself and they'll either like it or not. If you're the type of guy that calls, then call and then they can get used to that or not. But you shouldn't text if you want to call or call if you want to text.
I email. I just do email.
It's much more formal.
I correspond
formal.
Only over tweeting.
Yeah,
it's sort of public, so it...
Not direct messages either.
No.
I actually do LinkedIn messages more than anything
else. Now you can DM people without them following you.
Really?
Yeah.
You can. That's not true.
Yes, I think that's the thing they're rolling out.
You can direct message anybody, whether they follow you or not?
I think... coming soon or already in it's a new development, but I think I saw some headline about this.
You know what we were talking about is
I've DM'd Angelina Jolie 27 times,
but she follows you.
Yeah, right.
Adding messages on Instagram.
Oh yeah, be a real game changer.
Ooh. Because it is kind of flirtatious to follow someone or like someone's photo in a super 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 lightweight passive way.
You want to know a new thing that I've been doing on
now
Instagram?
You're speaking my language.
English.
This is someone, like, if there's a picture of someone, and rather than like it, I will text them and be like, I like that picture.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
So you like someone's photo on Instagram and you text them and say, I like their photo?
I won't like it on Instagram. I'll see it and I'll text them and I'll be like, I like that picture.
Why not like it on Instagram in addition to saying you like it via text?
I don't know.
Because you're saying you're bigger than the people who just like,
swing the bat right here.
But not really, because you're just texting.
But I think she will, I mean, anyone public, you know, would want the public liking as well.
Yeah, I don't do it a lot, but like if something's really good on Instagram, if a girl looks really good in a picture, I'll text.
Oh, pictures of her. I assume you made pictures like her dog or something.
If, like, it's a picture of a tree, I'm just going to scroll past it.
I liked your tree photo, heart for eyes emoji.
What, is that a spruce? Because it looked like a spruce to me.
No, it wasn't.
Oh, okay.
Birch,
cool.
Then? Elm?
Then you like it on Instagram.
Am I getting warm?
You like it and dislike it 40 times so she gets the notification on her phone. Sorry, I'm freaking out over here.
I had a thing last night where someone posted a tweet that I thought was really funny, and then I tried to like it or retweet it, I can't remember, and it was like unavailable. They had deleted it in that brief period of time, and I wanted to text. I took a screen cap of the tweet to have it, and I was going to text them and be like, hey, just so you know, I like that tweet.
Oh.
You didn't have to delete
it. Was it
that.
A girl?
It was a girl, but not a girl. It's a girl that has a boyfriend, so it's not like it wasn't a sexual thing.
It's always a sexual thing.
No.
You got to lay the groundwork, man, because that relationship's going to come crumbling down.
No, especially you lay pipe till you've done the groundwork. You lay the groundwork, then you lay the pipe.
What?
You lay the groundwork, then you lay the pipe.
I think that's one of the opening quotes from the episode of The Wire, when they put like in text.
It fades in and then it fades out.
Don't come at the king unless you the king.
Bodie.
Honk. Bodie. You know what? Who's on The Walking Dead? I just started watching The Walking Dead.
Oh, yeah.
There's two people. Cuddy?
Yeah, Cuddy's been on it since last season.
But also, now on it is, what's his face?
Yeah, I'm trying to remember now, too.
Where's Wallace?
Yeah, where's Wallace? What's his name?
D'Angelo.
We never did the Where's Waldo.
Where's Wallace, String?
Where's Waldo hardly working?
Oh, that's funny.
Where's Waldo at? Where's Waldo, String?
Where the fuck's Waldo at?
Yeah, the Shaw for Shaw remake.
Oh, yeah, we haven't done one of those in a while.
Yeah.
Those were kind of cool.
All right.
We haven't done one. Cool. I would love to do another one.
Are we still recording?
We're just eating brunch now.
Sorry, you're bringing me into a rabbit hole of actual career stuff.
Did we answer this person's question?
I don't think we did, actually. And here's how I'm going to do it. I think you just have to be confident and open. As a girl, especially here at this school where you're surrounded by guys and you're one of the few girls, which is why I imagine you're saying it's like shooting fish in a barrel, you just have to don't seem closed off. And I mean, feel totally cool going up and saying hey to a guy. It doesn't mean... it's not like a huge risk to just say hi. You can be friends.
Because you know what? If I was at that school, I'd be like, I don't want to talk to these girls because I need to. I don't want to be like one of the 30 guys that comes up to them. Like that's not going to make me feel good. I don't want to feel like one of the 50 guys who are ogling over.
Yeah, so you know what? Yeah. You're like, everybody's probably looking at you. Go up and talk to somebody. Also, of course, you're rusty. You're just getting out of a relationship. So just keep on practicing, keep on flirting, and then you're going to get more confident. You're going to get better.
That depends. Are you like a 5 or a 7?
She's a 7. She could stand to lose some weight, I bet, right? You fucking monster.
Oh, God. That guy already broke up with her. It's the guy from the first question.
I agree with Jake. Yeah. I think that's, you know, it sounds like you're in, you know, just...
Go for it.
All these engineering students, they're going to want...
Yeah, or at the very least, like their photo on Instagram. That way it sort of lays the pipework, is that what you said? Lay the groundwork.
And then you can lay the pipe. Laid, okay.
We should call this episode, Episode 30, with Pat Cassels. should we take a break, or should we just go on to the last question?
We've only answered 2, so I feel like we haven't really necessarily earned a break.
But how many do you do in total?
We usually do between 3 and 5. But
so we're halfway through.
But the problem is we don't like to go over much over 40 to 50 minutes. We're already around the 40-minute mark.
Oh, wow. So let's just answer one last question.
But break and then answer or just go into it?
I could do a break because I have to pee.
Oh, no. This isn't a real break. But you can go pee and me and Jake could talk. We're going to keep – we just keep talking through the break. We just sort of mentally unwind.
I'm not I don't trust you guys enough
He's
to leave.
He's pissing. Holy in the shit. Chair.
You dick.
He's taking a stand.
I didn't know. You guys weren't clear.
He's running a marathon.
Yeah.
What's up to you?
We wanted to talk about Comic-Con or something.
Oh, yeah. Oh, Comic-Con, yeah.
You went to Comic-Con.
As you guys did as well.
Yeah.
How did you like Comic-Con?
I liked it. It was, but my, this year, was the briefest I've ever been there in many years.
Yeah. 3 full days.
Slept in the Javits Center.
Camped out for the Thor the Dark World panel. Saw Chris Hemsworth as he was coming in. I shit you not.
I grabbed his ankle and I held on for a full 2 minutes before I was wrestled away by security.
Dude was chowing down on an Energy Kitchen burger wearing an Under Armour t-shirt. I'm not making this up. I'm not.
Energy Kitchen burger.
No, I went for the show. I co-hosted a show with Owen Parsons.
Uh-huh.
And then I kind of left after that. And the next 2 days I went home. So I gave my pass away.
That's beautiful.
Yeah.
We did the same thing.
Yeah.
Who'd you give your passes to?
Our sweethearts, actually. We gave our passes to our sweethearts. We met them at the Comic-Con.
Oh, wow. Yeah, yours was
pinned them.
A female Inuyasha and you were a Batwoman.
Batwoman, yeah. Yeah.
Is Batwoman a thing? Isn't it just Catwoman?
I believe Batwoman is a recent, more recent character, but I do believe there's a Batwoman. I will be corrected on this, I'm sure, if I'm wrong, but yeah.
No, we'll be corrected. You won't get these emails, but we'll get the 30,000 emails that I'll take.
Well, we on this podcast unequivocally say there is a Batwoman.
Me, Jake, and Amir all agree Batwoman does exist.
Also, Val Kilmer was the best Batman.
What do you think is a better Halloween costume for me, Velma or Ned Flanders?
I mean, I'm going as Psy, so...
Don't take my opinion.
Ned Flanders would be great for you. You should definitely do that.
All I need is to... Because he has glasses. All I need is a mustache.
Ned Flanders is a dope costume.
Would I have to face paint yellow?
I don't think you should. I don't like...
Oh, yeah. Last year, Dave Rosenberg was Marge Simpson. It was so funny. He got
play that night, I think.
He did.
Didn't he dye his pubes blue? Oh, no. You know what? He had just fucked a pie. That's what it was.
What's your
bold move?
I really think I would love for you to be Velma. I think there would be nothing better than that.
Velma? Yeah. I just need the wig.
It's so funny. Cross dressing.
I thought of going as Tina last year and then I decided against it.
Tina Fey?
From Bob's Burgers. I went as I actually don't have a costume lined up. I was gonna go as Neo, but then the costume I wound up buying was crappy, so that's out the window.
So crappy you couldn't even be Neo.
Blurred Lines. If any girls are willing to be the Miley to my Robin Thicke for my Blurred Lines costume.
I bet a lot of girls would, especially now that you say it on this podcast.
Costume of the brooch to your girlfriend, like, baby, you know, couples costume. Blurred Lines.
Actually, this is a perfect segue to our last question of the day. You guys want to get into it?
Let's do it.
Give me one more dude's name.
Tyrell.
Tyrell writes, "Hey guys, longtime fan, but I've run into a bit of trouble. So I'm at college out of state, and my girlfriend of a year is still back at home. Halloween's coming up, and a girl I've met here wants to do a couple's costume. My girlfriend doesn't want me to do it because she thinks it's cheating, but I think it would just be fun. I'm pretty sure she'd never find out if I did it, but if she did, she'd be super pissed at me. What should I do? P.S. Go Bills."
Go Bills. It's not cheating. Let's just be clear about that right off the bat.
I think it is a little bit of an emotional cheat.
It's not, well, that's, it's not cheating.
It's not physically
what
cheating.
What does this girlfriend think, like, oh, yeah, if you, like, watch TV, if you look at girls, that's cheating.
Well, not looking, looking like, at girls is one thing, but couple's costume is an emotional cheat.
It's not a cheat.
It's an emotional cheat.
I completely disagree.
It really is an emotional
cheat. Well, what's the costume?
It's very intimate.
That's an important aspect.
Oh, it's two Siamese twins 69ing. It's two girls, one cup. He's the cup.
It's two people intertwined in an erotic tangle.
It's the John Lennon Yoko Ono poster.
God, I don't know. I think maybe I'm a little more on Amir's side. Like, I just, it's by definition, it's a couple's costume. Like,
yeah.
The word couple is right in there.
Yeah, but like, you know,
would you
what?
Be down if your girlfriend wanted to be a couple's costume with another dude?
Yeah. But well, I mean, that's because I probably.
That's because I'm a super chill dude who's like.
That's because I've never liked anyone.
No, I think. Well, first of all, I don't think you should even have a girlfriend. That's a different. That's a different.
Yeah, that's
question.
Just because you don't think anyone can have a girlfriend because, once again, you've never liked anybody.
I don't believe in monogamy. I don't believe in love.
Yeah. So you're saying couple's costume is like, it's just a fun thing. There's nothing romantic or even like flirtatious about it.
Yeah. I mean, if he wants to do it and his girlfriend is saying he can't and she's like, dampening his college experience, then he should just break up with his girlfriend and do it. And, and follow up, if you want to do it, if you want to do it, but you don't want to upset your girlfriend, why don't you suggest to this girl a bigger group costume rather than a couple's costume? Because then you can be like,
good.
A whole crew of friends are going out as like the Avengers or something, you know, like then you can do, you still have like the camaraderie, but you don't have to upset your girlfriend.
But then other people are, I mean, to me, this is, God. It's just sad. Maybe I'm being cynical.
No, group costume means like you cheated on her in an orgy. How dare you, actually?
This unreasonable girlfriend. Everything is cheating. Even if you dress up as Neo from The Matrix, you're just dressed up as someone who doesn't have a girlfriend, so you're acting single.
Then I'm not even in reality. I'm in a computer simulation. I can do whatever I want. I'm not really cheating on you. I'm cheating on a bunch of ones and zeros.
She just thinks Halloween is real.
What, you're gonna just dress up as someone and be them?
Holy crap, I'm dating the wolf man? You're half wolf and you never told me?
Fuck me, this sucks.
This is incredible.
This happens to me every Halloween.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, that group caught you. That's good advice, man. You give good advice.
I appreciate that.
But also, like,
have you thought about starting a podcast?
To me, there's this, even with, like, I guess now I'm just like, this is a guy, right, that wrote this?
Yeah, yeah.
There's almost this subtext of like, he probably kind of likes this girl, right?
Yeah.
Like, I don't, like,
it is inherently flirty.
So then the group costume's kind of diluting that. Then it's you have a bunch of jabronis encroaching on your intimate moment with that girl.
I bet he just started school, just met this girl. She wants to be in a couple's costume with him. He's already regretting the relationship.
But the thing is, it is flirty. I think your girlfriend should get over it, though, because it's like your time to like have fun and do this kind of thing. But if she's not going to, then I think, and if you like this girl at all, then I mean, shit, you guys are young. You guys should have this college experience.
Yeah, you just want that. I feel like in college, if you liked a girl, you would just have to like turn into like the Terminator and just be like, I'm not leaving your side. It's a little creepy, I guess,
right.
But you have to be like, I really want to hang out with you. I really want to make a mental connection with you in the next 4 hours, so you don't forget about me tomorrow.
Yeah.
Was I not talking to the microphone?
You were, but okay. Not as much as you could have been.
Sorry. Am I ruining audio wise? I think I've been like hovering there.
No, you've been good so far. Yeah. I was just, yeah. I was thinking about that.
Cool. I hear it. I'm back.
Your eyes started bleeding.
Anyway. But yeah. I'm so curious what the couple's costume is. I wish they had that detail.
I bet I can email and then maybe, nah, he's not going to get back to me in time. In the next 2 seconds before we end this podcast.
Hey, dude.
Well, this is just another reason to break up with your girlfriend if you go to college and they don't.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're gonna meet some really totally pleasant 18 or 19 year old one day, and they'd be like, "Hey, you're an asshole. You convinced my boyfriend to dump me, or you convinced my girlfriend to dump me." It's brash when we just tell young kids in love to break up and hook up with other people in college, but it is fun. I mean. I don't know. Fuck.
I think we're making. I sense in you, Jake, there's a genuine attempt to want to help. You know. And
I sense in you, Jake.
I sense the force is strong with you.
Oh my God, his hands are sticky.
Always sticky.
Always sticky, never icky, Nature Box. What's your bold move?
Hashtag, remember the bold girls will be at McGillicuddy's from 4 a.m. to 7 a.m. giving out Coors Lights.
Shaking their boulder holders.
Are you bold?
Whoa.
Oh, it's my phone, sorry.
Who is it?
I'm sorry.
Is that the ring?
That's...
It's Smooth Jazz?
You pimp!
It's because he only gets calls from debt collectors. So it's like, I just... Like, it stresses me out. It's
I need
like,
to calm
like,
down.
Hey, baby. Ooh, hey, Pat. Yeah, you still owe us $2,900 in back taxes. All right. Ass. Very cool.
I'm feeling good. It's actually the theme song from Hill Street Blues, which is an 80s cop show. You're right. It is Smooth Jazz, technically speaking. That was that. I believe that was my the subletter for in Los Angeles that I'm having problems with right now.
I am going through some shit, so I really appreciate being on the show.
My credit.
Anything you want to plug, Pat? Just I need a place to crash when I'm in LA.
Would love the Holiday Inn Express.
If anybody's listening from a DoubleTree or some shit, I know you guys are
there's
never at full capacity.
If there's a clerk, whatever, the valet. If you get a discount, hook me up.
My life is just. In a shake it up snow globe right now.
All right. We are more than out of time, actually. Thanks
more
for
than.
Thanks for coming on the show.
Thanks for having me. This was so fun.
Yeah. Yes.
And where should we direct people to go if they want to hear more Pat or get more of your stuff?
Follow me on Twitter. It's Patrick_Cassels.
Why? Why underscore?
Because some Scottish dude is Patrick Cassels.
Wow. Underscore.
I've been told I can, like, if I want to, like, write to Twitter, I can like maybe make a case, but yeah. I don't know. I'm fine. I feel like I you know. So that also collegehumor.com where I work.
Just some real brief housekeeping with that email again. If you wanted to email us and ask your own questions that we can get to, is ifiwereyoushow@gmail.com. We're still accepting, reviewing, and taking in user theme song submissions. That first one was from a guy named KNOFLE. Knoffel. And we are still giving out shout-outs to people who are reviewing our show on iTunes. It really helps us out. So thank you so much, Ethan Poo, Courtney Estelle, Sparkles1317, Maddie JJJ, and Perk6608 for leaving a good review on our page.
You're the best.
You're not even happy when you do it.
Nah, it's like a weird tick that I can't help.
There are still some tickets available left for our show, our
but
live
show.
But
not a lot, so get them now.
Yeah, yeah. It's at Littlefield in Brooklyn on November 6th. Ooh. Actually, you should buy a ticket, man. I really would appreciate it.
I don't think I'll be. I think I'll be in LA at that
point. I know. We don't need you to come. We just need a little boost of good little ticket sales.
How much is it?
No, it has to be through the site. It really does have to be through the site.
I would accept $7 right now.
Cash.
Wow, you guys are leaning in on me really closely.
This whole podcast is extortion, I think. It's not even plugged in.
I would love to go to that. I'm sorry I can't.
Oh, no, it's okay.
I will be out of town. I really want to go.
Maybe we'll do one in L.A.
Hopefully we'll
That'd
do
be
one
awesome.
In L.A.
I'm trying to remember who... Oh, yeah, and the last theme song, our outro theme song today is from a guy named Garrett. So, yeah, thanks for listening to this episode. Episode 30.
Hell yeah.
Who'd have thought we would have get here? And to be here with you, Pat...
I'm honored.
It really is uneventful.
Okay, wow.
No, thanks for coming on. You are definitely... No guys, problem. Please rank the guests. I would love to know where you guys think Pat stacks. Oh, shit.
It's 30 episodes old, so now it's like... It's not ready for kids, but it wants a dog.
Just like Jake.
There we go.
Yeah, enjoy the rest of your day. I don't know. I don't know how to end
you
this
You always
yet.
Say enjoy.
Yeah, I hope you enjoyed.
Yeah, there you go.
Later.
Peace.
If you're having a bad day, dark clouds just won't go away. Take a load off with Shane Haehh. Send white people problems their way. Promise it'll be hashtag dope. Unless you're a dick, then it hashtag won't. And bitches are all of them. We go to ifiwereyoushow@gmail.com.
Unless it's about STDs.